All right, good afternoon. So welcome to the Queensborough Community College Student Government Election Forum. This is your chance to see and hear the candidates who are running for student government this year. My name is James Accardino. I'm the NYPIRG Project Coordinator at Queensborough Community College, and I'll be your moderator for this afternoon's event. And yeah, today you're going to be hearing from the candidates running for office. So a little bit on voting in the student government elections. At QCC, every matriculated student has the right to vote in student government elections. It does not matter if you are a day student or a night student, or whether you're full-time or part-time or anything like that. As long as you're a matriculated student, you have the right to vote. And it is important that you all exercise that right. The QCC student government officers make decisions that impact the student body. The student government budget, which they administer, is worth over $250,000. Members of student government represent the student body on campus-wide committees, in addition to that, and meetings with administration, faculty, and staff. The members of student government play a big role on campus when it comes to student life and advocating for the student body. And by voting, you can make your voice heard in selecting our student leaders. If you do not vote, you can't complain later. And when you do vote, you should be an informed voter, and you should get to know the candidates, know what their positions are, what issues they're advocating on, what they say they're going to do if they're elected, their qualifications. Ultimately, all of that is why we are here today. So before we even go any further, I want to quickly explain how the voting is going to be conducted. Voting is already open, actually. It opened at 12:01 a.m. on today, Wednesday, April 6th, and the polls will be open until Wednesday, April 13th at 9 p.m. An email from the Office of Student Activities with the subject line Student Government Elections 2022 has already been sent to everybody's QCC student email account, and that email has all of the information that you will need to vote. Now, with all that in mind, let's talk about the procedure for today's candidate forum. We're going to be going through each of the different positions, and we'll be starting with the president and then going through each of the offices from there. So candidates running for the same position will be asked the same question, and then you'll have a minute and a half or 90 seconds to respond. So in other words, everybody running for president will get the same question. Everyone running for executive vice president will get the same, et cetera. In the order of positions will be president, executive vice president, administrative vice president, programming vice president, treasurer, vice president for part-time students, vice president for evening students, senators at large, allocation committee, judicial committee, and finally the student faculty disciplinary committee. And for each of the positions, we will be calling on the candidates in alphabetical order by last name. So now that we have our introduction out of the way, let's go right into it and start hearing from our candidates. So we are going to start with the Office of the President, as I said, and the candidates for president. Ray has kindly posted in the chat a little bit of an explanation about the role of the president, which basically is the head of the student government, responsible for overseeing executive board, and represents student government at a variety of different functions. So the candidates for president, just to go through that list very quickly, we've got Real Reed Carr, Sadil Mitchell, Vladislav Molchanov, Kazia Prince, and Navneet Sandhu. So we're going to start at the top of that list. And the question for all of you, by the way, will be, simply put, if elected, what is your vision for QCC? So going from the top, Real Reed, are you here? It's looking like our first candidate is not present at the moment. So we are going to go down the list to the next person. So it's the answer for that, by the way, Vlad asks, is there one question or several? You'll have one question to answer, and you'll have 90 seconds for it. And Ray will be keeping track of the time, by the way, so you've got that in mind. So yes, we can type the question in the chat. Absolutely. I'll put that in there right now. So let's go down the list here and really get going here. So Sadil Mitchell, if you could unmute, you've got 90 seconds as soon as you're ready to answer that question of if elected, what would you do? Or rather, what's your vision for QCC?
Well, yes, sir. My vision for QCC is to be a true leader for everybody who needs me. You see, I am a director of a board company here in Eastern Queens that handles multiple events and stuff of that sort. I intend to guide everybody, referring to everybody, the QCC students with my knowledge and Buddha wisdom. I have an old saying that I wrote up a long time ago. Sometimes onyx is more valuable than diamond. And well, you guys know how diamonds are usually valuable, but sometimes, you know, diamonds are not worth much for the effort they have. I can be an onyx. I don't want to end up winning being just a dark horse, but I do want to make sure I win this as honorably as possible. And one thing in my candidacy as vision for QCC is to lead with honor and wisdom. That is my vision. I intend to guide everyone through my Buddha Shinto wisdom. If there's anything a student needs, I will listen to them, even if I have to work alone. Thank you.
All right, thank you very much for your answer there. So continuing down the list of candidates for president, Vladislav Milkonov, you are next. So as soon as you're ready, you can answer the question of, if elected, what's your vision for QCC?
My name is Vladislav Molchanov, my vision for QCC, if elected, is better mental health for students, better quality of our education, and better food on campus. As a multiracial community, as QCC, we are all different people and we come from different backgrounds. I acknowledge that our cultures bring different things to our school. But what's the same for all of us? I think that's the question, what's for lunch? One of the things that one part of my campaign is bringing up and running all of the kitchens on QCC. I plan vetting the information with COVID regulations and see if we can open this. The last thing about the quality education, I've noticed that the labs that happens in our school need some improvement, the lab equipment, the schedule of the classes could be done better. I would like to work with my team on solving those issues and bringing them up to the administration and finding the solutions. And then, thank you.
So the next candidate down the list, continuing down, Kezia Prince, same question for you.
Hi, I'm Kezia Prince, and my vision for QCC is basically just excellence. I believe that every matriculated student in QCC has their own unique voice and their own unique talents. And I'm all about bringing that to light. We have a lot of students in our school who are just maybe shy, or they just don't know how to speak for themselves or just come forth with themselves. I'm putting myself in the ring. If elected, I'm going to have a team of group to put themselves in the ring as well, bringing forth those students who have this amazing voice and this talent, who doesn't know how to, you know, stand up for themselves or be themselves. I'm here to help them. I'm giving every student the opportunity to be involved, whether by having student jobs, whether by being a peer counselor, who don't feel comfortable speaking to an adult, I'm giving them stuff to speak to. I will lead with kindness. I'm going to lead with grace and respect, and always keep in mind that I represent the student body. So I must have respect for myself and respect for everyone in the school. No matter if it's teacher, student, whoever you are, respect is the entire thing. And yeah, that's pretty much all my vision is for the school.
Excellent. Thank you very much for your answer. For now, we're going to move down the list to our next candidate. Also, I sincerely apologize if you hear my cat in the background. She is really missing my roommate, but regardless, distractions aside, Executive Vice President is the next office that we've got here. And we have three candidates running for that position. And as again, Ray has put the description of the role in the chat. One of the many responsibilities is responsibility for the student senate and being second in command in the student government. So the three candidates are Brianna Gilzean, Samantha Roberts, and Shanila Vasquez. And we'll be going in that order, which is last name alphabetical. So Brianna, and for all of you as well, the question will be, if elected, what will you do for the student body? Going once, going twice. I do not believe she is in the meeting. Okay. So we'll go to the next candidate, Samantha Roberts. You are up with that same question.
Hi, everybody. Thank you so much for coming out today to this meeting and sharing your time. If elected, I promise to act in the most beneficial interest for the success and growth of Queensborough. I plan to be a transparent leader that is dedicated to rebuilding the community of Queensborough as well. And I plan to be accessible, ready, and willing to listen to any student that has any issues. And part of my focus is to grow student involvement with clubs and activities and create more outlets for academic assistance. I believe that all of these components are important and much needed, especially with the repercussions of COVID and the pandemic. I hope to build better communications between other students and myself, between Senate, the President, and the Executive Board. If elected, I promise to, like I said, be a leader that acts beneficial for the interests of the school and the student body. Thank you.
All right. Going down the list of executive vice president candidates, last one is Shanila Vasquez. You are here.
Hi, everyone. It's very hard to not repeat what others have said since they have really good ideas. But something that I feel being an executive vice president do is also be like the second hand, the second help, not only the second most important. And that's something that I'm planning to do, be able to help students as much as QCC has helped me as a pandemic student. And I feel as a way of showing my appreciation to the school is serving students whenever they need. I do feel like as I work here, QCC, I'm able to see more students. I'm able to help them to be more accessible whenever they need. And especially as a nursing program, as a nursing student, I feel even the nursing students, they don't have enough help to get into a nursing program. So by this, I'm not saying that I'm only going to help the nursing students, but in general, everyone with student sessions to help them get better grades and things like that. So if you vote for me, I'll be able to have a better communication with students, staff. And yeah, thank you for your time.
So the next position up is the administrative vice president. Yes, the descriptions we put into the chat. Administrative VP is responsible for the ratification committee, which certifies student clubs to exist on campus, as well as chairing the student club president meetings and also recording and keeping track of club events. So the question for administrative VP, I'm going to throw into the chat as well. The administrative VP works closely with student clubs and groups, as we just said. So the question is really, what do you hope to accomplish in that role? And the candidates for administrative VP are Carissa Davis, Jerry Lee, Luke Menaja, and Maria Pachon. We are going to start with Carissa. Here that Carissa is here. So we're going to move down the list to Jerry.
Hey, how's it going, everyone? Hope everyone's having a great day. As the administrative vice president, I hope to be able to build a greater sense of community here at Queensborough Community College. I mainly want to be able to help others find other people with a shared common interest. Obviously, after the pandemic, it has become like extremely hard to be able to find new friends and be able to grow a sense of community here. So as the admin VP, I hope to be able to remedy that issue. I hope to accomplish this by ratifying more clubs. Over the past few weeks, I've had a couple of people that are, I would like to call friends, come up to me with ideas such as an animation club and a true crime or unsolved mysteries club. So I hope to be able to ratify these during my time in office, and I believe these are valuable clubs because they not only help foster a greater sense of community, but they also give you real world experience and knowledge that you'll be able to take out into the working field. Thank you.
Going down, Luke is next.
Hi, everyone. If I were to be voted, I would like to help students find clubs that they're interested in, and also to add more clubs like my previous partner said, and also to help students figure out what they want in QCC, because as I understand, we have many clubs, which is amazing, but it also gets difficult because all the clubs meet within one day and one time. So it's hard to really say, oh, I would like to join two clubs, and you can't do that because you're in one club and you can't transition to the other one. And so I would like to also help clubs find the perfect time for which they want to meet together, so that way students can have more availability to different clubs instead of just joining one club in particular. And that'll be all. Thank you.
Maria, last but not least, you are here. We can go ahead. And I do not believe that she is in the meeting. We are going to continue our rolling through our candidates and our positions here, and we're going to move on to the programming vice presidents. Got a description in the chat. The programming vice president is responsible for planning a variety of events on social, educational, and cultural programs in particular. They also chair the Activities Program Council, the APC, which is one of the many committees in the student government. So we have two candidates running for this position, and they are Brené Díaz-Miller and Silvia Quiñones. And the question for both of you will be simply put, what are your ideas to engage the student body in extracurricular activities? Brené Díaz, you are first.
Okay. I'm going right, Silvia?
Brené Díaz was first, but it doesn't seem that she's in the meeting. So you are next, Silvia. So I was about to say, go right ahead.
Okay, perfect. Hi, everyone. My name is Silvia Quiñones. This is my second year at Queensborough Community College. As I say in my campaign video, I want to bring to QCC more than social programs, but culture. I know a lot of people who study in QCC, they're not from US, so they're like from another places. I'm from Colombia. So what I want to do is bring culture. Like I put an example. If I'm from Colombia, I would like the QCC to put activities of my country. Let's see, a student from Colombia, they're not into school programs, and they see the QCC is doing an activity that bring to promote their culture. We might have the chance to gain that person and make them part to be of the, you know, student body. So that's what I want to do. I'm very passionate and compromised when I do something. And I love to have a conversation with the students and allow them to express their ideas. So that way we can see how we can make the QCC even greater place. Thank you.
We're going to move into the next position, which is a treasurer. The treasurer is responsible for keeping track of the SGA budget, over $250,000, it's approximately $300,000, and also chairs the allocation committee, which is the committee that figures out how to best award budgets to student clubs and groups. So we have one candidate running for this office, Paladin Bhutia is running for that. If you are here, it does not appear that they are here. So we're going to move into the next candidate, the next position then in that case. So we're going to be talking about the vice president for part-time students position here. The VP for part-time students advocates for part-time students. It's in the name. And in particular, that position assists in event programming as a member of the Activities Programming Council, with an eye on part-time students, of course. So the candidates for that position, we have Allison Rodriguez and Hafiz Tariq. And the question is very simple. What are your plans for part-time students? So we're going to start with Allison, if you are here. All right, it's looking like Allison is not present with us at this moment. So Hafiz, you're next.
Hey, how are you? So my biggest goal for the part-time student is to create a part-time student's resource body. You know, as a part-time student, last semester I was a part-time student. And before coming to a part-time student, I was a student, with CSTAP, ASAP scholarships. and they were paying for my books and everything, right? When I got a part-time student, like, I was not able to pay for my books. So I want to advocate for part-time students to have these kind of resources. Also, this part-time resource body for the student part-time students will have, you know, all the needed resources. For example, I'm ambitious to create like a peer-to-peer relationship for part-time students. Also, like events, including I can, you know, create events. I can, you know, I can invite people like Stephanie Atkins or the Miss Francesca that has like a lot of resources. Although they cannot, you know, offer them a lot like metro cards or money for the books, but they can all provide them, you know, career opportunities. That is very important for the part-time students. Part-time student means you have a full-time job and other responsibilities on top of like a schoolwork. So your commitment, I want to advocate for that. And I want to have like part-time students, same resources as other students. So they will succeed in their student life, not academically, but like being as a student.
Those were the candidates for vice president for part-time students. The next position going down our list here, we'll be speaking to the candidates for vice president for evening students. So the VP for evening students, they advocate for evening students, very, very similar position, but for evening students, of course, also assisting in event programming in APC. So the three candidates for this position are Emily Diana, Eleni Skouloudis, and Odette Vasquez. And the question for y'all with 90 seconds is very simple. What are your plans for evening students? So we are going to start with Emily. As soon as you're ready, go ahead.
Oh, I apologize about my dogs. Something happened outside and they're very loud. But basically my plan for evening students is to try to find ways to get them involved. I feel like a lot of evening students are already tired when they come to class and like they're just trying to finish their work and get out, and there's not really an opportunity for them to socialize. So I want to find ways to get them involved, either, you know, online on the weekends, you know, hours that are more convenient to them, but and still make them feel like they're just as valued as the rest of us, you know, part-time students and regular like daytime students like myself. But yeah, I just want them to have a sense of community, whatever they feel like they also need. I'm more than willing to help them get, you know, bring up ideas to the rest of the student body. But I just want them to, you know, feel like they're as much as a student as the rest of us, even if they're going to class while it's dark outside.
Eleni, you are up next.
Okay, hi, my name's Eleni. Oh, I don't know why this is flipped. I'm sorry. I look really funny. I don't know why it's flipped. But so to represent evening students, I feel like is very important because I do go to school during the daytime, but I do have a lot of night classes. And I've noticed that the population really goes down by the end of the day. There's not, just like Emily said, there's not really a lot of socialization for the students, which I agree on. So I feel like we should have try to get like more nighttime clubs or even just a place for everybody to socialize at night. Like the student union closes at 7 o'clock, which is like a pretty good time, I feel like. But some students are like, I see when I get out of my class at like 8:30, I see some kids still in class by like 9. So I feel like afterwards, if they don't want to go home immediately, there should be like a place to do homework and socialize. I know it is hard with the times right now and like with things being open on our campus, but I feel like that would be a great idea. And I feel like at night students, they kind of go to school more casually. They don't really think about it since it's late and they're just going to get out. They feel like they don't really have, I guess you could say a purpose, but they don't really have motivation to go. It's kind of just like, oh, let me go at 5 and I'll be out by, you know, 8 or 9. So I feel like students should have more of a sense of purpose and like determination on like why they want to get their degree and like the reason they're going there in the beginning. So yeah.
Odette, you are up next. Does not look like they are here, however. I was just giving a second there, but in that case, move on to the next position, which is the student senator at large position, which is multiple positions. So the student senators, they serve functionally as a check and balance on the on the Student Government Executive Board, and they also are student representatives on various academic senate committees. So we have a number of candidates running for these positions. We have Maxine Chang, Maria Diaz, Zirka Mel-Dosseli, Brian Farr, Nat Lee, Chibuike Obadegwu, and Mohamed Mabalo. So we are going to go in that order. The question, by the way, for y'all is very simple as well. Simply, what do you hope to accomplish as a senator at large? So we are going to start with Maxine. Are you here?
Yes, I'm here. Excellent. Really didn't want to go first, but my name is Maxine. I'm a write-in for the candidates. So sort of weird, but my responsibilities would be to vote and monitor the executive. As for what I'd accomplish in the Senate at large, I want to work with many different committees of QCC. Some of the committees that stood out to me would be the e-learning committee and the student activities committee. I want to work with those, and if I am to be elected, I want to put in the work and effort in order to make a better experience for all of us in QCC.
So we are going to continue down the list. Maria Diaz, going once and twice. Zirka Mel, you're next. Going down the list, Brian Farr, you are up next. Is Brian here? Nah, you are next. Okay. continuing down our list. Chibuike, you're next. I see you here.
Good afternoon, everybody. My name is Chibuike Obidegwu, but you can call me Chibi. Yeah, I'm sorry, I'm at work, so I just had to like step aside to just do a quick talk. So my goals and like my major goal of being a student senate is to make sure that the any documents coming from the executive board, my role is to make sure that I give a good decision. And also I want to bring up some clubs and some sporting activities. When I came into this college, I noticed some of the students, Africans, they would just go home, don't like talk to people, and it's not good. You have to, as a classmate, you have to.
We seem to be experiencing some kind of technical difficulty.
Yeah, are you back? Yeah, you disconnected for a second. But if you're here, we can stay back on.
Yeah, I can hear you then. So I was like saying about the after class, like the student, they would just go, don't like talk to one another, and which is not good. You have to communicate. So I want to bring about more sporting activities, you know, more clubs, and also I'm going to work with the committee, like the sporting committee, you know, try to get some experience and also play a good role. That's it.
Continuing down our list, Mohamed.
Hello, my name is Mohamed. I'm an engineering student in my second semester, and I'm running for senator with the goal of the senator is basically like being a medium between students and administration. And their goal is to best represent the student body. So to be able to do that, I plan on having bi-weekly meetings with students, with my fellow students, so that I am constantly updated on new suggestions or new concerns that come up, and basically being more in touch with the student body and knowing exactly what they want during different periods of time. And also, I'd like to promote academic initiative because I feel as if that's very important for student development. So any motions that come across that I feel as if will improve or will encourage academic engagement among students, I'll vote for. And also, I'd also like to promote a stronger community within students, because like being a student, especially during COVID, is hard. So like being more of a like centralized community, helping each other out and anything of that sort is very helpful for students. So as senator, I'd like to be more accessible to students so they can easily reach out to me if anything comes up. Thank you very much.
And that was all the candidates for student senator at large. Thank you all. We are continuing down our list here. We are now up to the allocation committee. You might have heard me briefly mention the allocation committee a little bit before, but I'll wait for the description to appear in the chat. Yes, they are indeed responsible for approving student club budgets. So I mentioned them during the charger description before. So we have two candidates running for seats on this committee. They are Diana Trotman and Nicole Penaloza. So the question for both of you will be, why did you choose to run for the allocation committee? Cool. We are going to start with Diana, if you are here. Diana Trotman, don't believe they are present here. So Nicole, you are up.
My name is Nicole Penaloza. And the reason I'm running is because I'm currently the president of a club here on campus. So I've seen firsthand how the budgeting has impacted clubs here. And budgeting has become an issue for so many clubs, especially after the pandemic. And my plan really is to team up with the SGA, such as the admin VP and other people that are also going to be working alongside me. And also listen really to the students and the club leaders on how to address budgeting issues from both a micro and a macro level.
That was allocation committee. We are next going to go into the judicial board. So they ensure adherence to the constitution of the student governments. So we have two candidates running for this position. Zua Du and Aisha Frampton Clerk. The question is very simple. Why did you choose to run for judicial board? Zua, are you here? Seems like not. Okay. Aisha, you are up next.
Hi, my name is Aisha Frampton Clerk and I'm running for judicial board. I chose to run for judicial board because I feel like upholding the constitution is a really important part of student government, and maintaining the order and balance that's written into it. It plays a huge role in making sure that everyone can do their job properly. So I wanted to be a part of that important role as a member of student government.
Are at our last position on the Student Faculty Disciplinary Committee. They decide on disciplinary cases dealing with faculty versus students, and they sit on a campus-wide board. There's one candidate running for that, which is also Diana Trotman, she does not appear to be in the meeting. That's all the candidates, it's all the positions. Was there anyone, I think we wanted to loop back just in the off chance that anyone who we might have missed before has joined us, going once, going twice. Okay, so that just about concludes everything. That was very excellent. Thank you to all the candidates for coming through and letting us know everything. So now that you've heard from the candidates, go out and vote. As mentioned earlier, an email from the Office of Student Activities, subject line, Student Government Elections 2022, has all of the information required that you need to vote, the link and all of that good stuff. It's been sent to your QCC student email accounts. You have until 9 p.m. on Wednesday, April 13th, 2022, to vote online for these very important positions. Good luck to all the candidates. And thank you all for coming on in. We've really appreciated your time today.
Good luck, everyone. Thank you, James, so much for hosting, moderating today's event. And thank you all the candidates who showed up. go out there and get those votes. If you have any questions, please stop by the office or email Gisela or myself, and you know, we'll respond, you know, fairly quickly to anything that you may have, any questions or issues or anything.